He joins us every week. Well, I could describe a few people, but he's particularly special. Ryan Doyle, co-host of Friendly Fire every night at 7 p.m. on News Talk 1010 Radio. Is it still called CFRB? That's the old days.
That's the old days. We're new school now.
You are new school. Brilliant show, wonderful ratings, and you're a talented fellow.
Thank you.
I first met you when you were so young, and the annoying thing is you've barely changed.
You actually took me out of my mother's womb, which I appreciated. And yes, I haven't changed one
bit.
You
don't have to be graphic about it.
I was actually dressed like this.
And it wasn't that early. You weren't always wearing a tie. But you're probably, you know, not too young or too old for Bill Clinton. The inauguration, lots of photos, candid photographs, because people are smiling, it's emotional and so on. Let's see the photo of Bill Clinton trying to look at Kelly Clarkson there. And, you know, perspective can be very, very damning and unfair. We have no idea what Bill Clinton's really looking at.
Really? I don't know. I mean, she fits the mold of the ladies that Bill Clinton happens to like. I mean, she's not wearing a black dress and isn't in his office right now, but he's probably thinking that. I love the fact that he's looking past Joe Biden, his fellow lech, who just had finished checking out Beyonce's behind. So, I mean, maybe this is symptomatic of those in the Democratic Party. I mean, obviously, we had John Edwards, who was stepping out on his wife. It would seem the Democrats...
Stepping out.
Well, in a big way.
I love your euphemism there.
I mean, it's one of those things where you look at it and these people are fairly lecherous. I mean, why would you be doing that with your wife sitting right there?
Because she's Hillary Clinton.
That could be a big part of it. She was.
I'm glad she's better anyway. But maybe you disagree. There is something about Bill Clinton I find difficult to condemn. I mean, I know what he is. I don't think he was a terrible president, but obviously he's a man who has a real issue with controlling his appetites. But there's something human about him.
Yeah, and the thing about Bill Clinton is he's smart, he's measured, and he isn't exactly one of those Democrats that you can hate. I mean, he is a very likable Democrat. He's a likable liberal. I do. I've got a long list, but he's not on it.
He is genuinely smart, and I think there's a greater sense of democracy and coexistence in him than there is in Barack Obama.
Yes, absolutely. And he's willing to... I think Bill Clinton would do a better job of the situation with the fiscal cliff, of agreeing with Republicans, finding middle ground. I think he would handle this situation a lot better than Barack Obama is currently handling this situation.
Prince Harry is someone else, Prince Harry, who has made the odd gaffe. And he's obviously the slightly more robust, less sophisticated one of the brothers. But he's a serving officer in the British Armed Forces, and he said in an interview that they've said to him, "Have you ever killed anyone?" And he said, "Yeah, you know, you take a life to save a life." And then he sort of compared it to a computer game, but I don't think he was trying to be offensive. Maybe he came across that way. It was only released, this interview, when he left Afghanistan, which is understandable. What he said, was it really so repugnant? I don't think
so. No, it was raw. It's how soldiers speak. And this is what the people, I think outside of the British press, people are, you know, taken aback by this. When we use our own North American, I guess, morals to have a look at what he said, we take a step back and think, well, you can't talk like that. He's a soldier. He's in combat. He knows that his fellow soldiers are on the ground and his duty in the air is to protect them. That's what he does. He takes out lives in order to save lives of his comrades, his people that he's serving shoulder to shoulder with. I like the fact that he speaks this ruggedly, that it's not all Hello Magazine, that it's not all airbrushed. It's raw. It's candid. Well, we need more people like him.
If we... There is some internal audio and video, particularly American pilots, and the way they're speaking is far more crass than this. They're talking as though it is actually a video game. They're killing people on the ground, or guys controlling drones, and their language is, again, maybe it's of the moment, but it seems rather clumsy. What he says, and he doesn't claim to be an intellectual, he's responding to a question. And yet,
but the thing
I'm not going to lie to you, I've killed someone, yes.
But we try to look at him as a prince and as a soldier, and I don't think you can do that. I don't think he is like his brother. He's not one of those people that's going to sit there with the crown and shake hands at dinner parties. He'd rather be in the back
crown.
Room. Well, I mean, he'd rather be in the back rooms having pints with his buddies, telling war stories.
Dressing up as Nazis and things like
that. Well, yeah, he's wild, he's eccentric, but that was in his youth. I like how just out there he is, how he doesn't give a damn about what everybody else thinks about him. I mean, think about the world we live in, how politically correct everybody is. Prince Harry is the exact opposite of all of that, and I applaud him for it.
Well, there are precedents. I mean, we think of British royalty. You know, Henry V was about 13 when he led troops into battle, and I do tend to agree with you. He's under scrutiny all the time, and I'm not a particular royalist nor a Republican. He's okay. He's a fairly ordinary person. And having met quite a few British officers from Army and Air Force in my time, a lot of rugby, a lot of beer, pretty decent guys. They put their lives on the line. Who am I to condemn, for goodness sake? Justin Bieber's mum. Justin, what a segue that was. Justin Bieber's mum, who is promoting a pro-life movie. Now, she's an evangelical Christian. Mm-hmm. She claims that her conversion really saved her life. Justin Bieber, again, not meant to be some great intellectually, just a pop star. He gave an interview once where to a Rolling Stone interviewer who did that, well, you know, abortion's a great thing, isn't it? He said, well, I don't know, is it really? Because it's taking a life. And he was then condemned for that. I admire this woman for standing up for what she believes
in. I do as well. And I think it's great that she says not only did Christianity save her life, it saved his. Mm. Because she said, I would have had an abortion if I didn't go another path. That means for all of those tens of millions of Justin Bieber fans out there, he wouldn't exist. So having her...
Why is a grin developing on my face?
Well, it shouldn't.
No, it shouldn't. Because we would not have had the music and talent of Justin Bieber if... Anyway, carry on.
It's one of those things, though, where his mom is basically saying, listen, my kid wouldn't exist. He wouldn't be there to entertain. You know, I'm not a fan of his music. I'm not going to pretend I am. But there are a lot of girls that will hear this message from her and think, oh, Justin Bieber, I like him. Maybe that'll resonate somewhere down the road where they say, well, maybe I won't have that abortion. And I think that's important.
Yeah, so music is entirely harmless. But not only that, there are a lot of incidents that we hear about with him where without any publicity, really, he's gone to help people. Kids who were ill, who couldn't get to concerts. And he seems to be quite a good kid. And what's the worst thing? Maybe he was smoking a joint, for goodness sake, big deal. Last story here, and it hasn't got much play, but this is a teacher in Ohio. And I saw an interview with her, and she was joking around with teenage kids at the school, and they were making a noise, and she put tape over their mouth. They all agreed it was a fun thing, and they posted the photographs on Facebook. And we have photographs. There's the teacher. That's a very unflattering picture, actually, because I saw her interview. But now they're threatening to fire her, and all the kids are saying, it was a joke. We were just playing around, and this is the only way I can keep them quiet. If you have to, there are abusive teachers who are still working because of the power of the unions. Here's a woman who was just trying to empathize with the kids and tease them slightly. It was all voluntary. She shouldn't lose her job.
No, definitely not. And you have to look at the woman's track record. If she's got a track record of abusing kids or being, you know, overly aggressive with children, then sure, you know, give her the axe based on that long history that she's got. But overall, I mean, this was a gag. This was fun. Yeah. Teachers can have fun in the school system. And if kids are getting along with it and everybody's fine, then why do we overreact so much to these type of things? It's political correctness run amok in our school system where teachers can't be human beings at the same time.
It is bewildering that teachers have to sit there and indoctrinate kids into various forms of sexuality where everybody is uncomfortable. But if they joke around whilst being a good teacher, they can lose their job. It's getting it both on, getting it wrong on both counts. It's a great shame.
It's a complete double standard, and this teacher should keep teaching. These are the good ones, right? These are the ones where the kids like them that you want to keep in the school system, and that's the way it should be.
Anybody in broadcasting, you can only keep quiet by putting tape over their mouth.
I try.
Don't answer that question.
Oh.
Thank you, mate.
Thank you.